money. It's still money. What time is it? Okay, it's still money. Good morning, good morning. We have new portion. Okay, so we've done the introduction. We have students here from Olabisi Onabanjo University Pharmacy School. That's in Shagami, Ogun State. And we have students from Federal University of Technology, Akure, Ondo State, one of my most favorite states in Nigeria. I did a lot of work on diabetes there. And FUNAB, Federal University of, what does the FUNAB mean? Federal University of, what does the N stand for? Yeah, but it's FUNAB. Federal Uni, okay, the Uni is the UN. Okay, and then agriculture, FUNAB. Okay. It makes some sense. All right, but FUNAB sounds nice. But the great thing is, it seems education is still alive and well in Nigeria. It literally died. It seemed dead at some point when everybody started sending their kids to Ghana and neighboring West African countries. But it seems like that's changing. Am I wrong? Eh? Am I wrong? Oh, people are still going to Ghana, have you? In Ibadan, we used to take care of the King of Saudi Arabia. So we have to bring back those days. I know all of you would love to just pick up and take off. Go to America, go to Europe, somewhere else. I want to encourage you not to give up in Nigeria. All of you here, being in the science field, you've chosen the field, and I hope you like the field you've chosen. Because if you do all the stuff you're supposed to do, you're going to be great. You know, so, well, I will start by just sharing a little bit of background with about myself. I have a lot to say, but I'm going to try to shorten things and just try to be, but we'll have a question and answer session, so because I want to listen to what you guys have to ask me and see if I can answer in the best possible way. So this is a little background about myself. I was born and raised here in Ajokuta, in the Shabo. We have our first female speaker of the House of Assembly. Her name is Titi Osedi. She is pretty much like my first sister. My mother delivered me in Shabo, so that there are so many children in my life. And her father and her family now. We were taken over to him, and he would bribe you with the candy, with the sweets, before giving you the actual your pride before you leave. So every time you have to go to their house, you know, first you're thinking about the sweets, but then you have to think about the invention. So this is a good one. So I spent my, you know, nursery and elementary school here at my mother's school, which is 57 years today. And from there on to a little bit of a school where I was about to move to my third year when I was the principal at Government College of Ghana came to my mother and said, "Hey, Mrs. Tammy, you need to send all that to Government College of Ghana. That I looked at my school, the standard falling that at the time." So my best friend at the time was Shino Obi, Ebenezer Obi's foster. So everywhere I go, Shino has to go. So my mother decided I was going to go. Now Shino had to come. Ebenezer Obi says, "No, my son must go to the school." It took a whole lot of convincing. My mother Obi has enough respect for my mother, so he changed his mind. And she and I went to Government College of Ghana. So We finished in 1981. I remember our last paper was agricultural science. That night we were on the flight from Lagos to New York to next step. Those are the golden days in Nigeria. ₦1 was equal to about $2. This comment, Ms. Jen, coming all the way from Lagos, Oriental, lovely place. Please have a seat. Ms. Jennifer. I'm Ms. Jennifer Ajebo. Is that right?
Yes.
Did I say it right?
Yes, you did.
Delta, that's all beautiful money. Okay? Who else is there? Is Shem here?
Yeah?
Yeah? Okay. Mr. Chair, you're doing a fantastic job. That's my wonderful PA. We're going to do something to work together. And so, sorry, I digress once in a while. But, so, now, we're at a public college, by the way, off to the U.S., so I started my